Hi friends, welcome to the series of Programming in C++. Today's topic is Containership. As we know that from the previous lectures, inheritance, in which, for example, class B is derived from class A. So we says that B is a kind of A because class B or derived class inherit the properties from the base class. So it acquires the properties or the features from base class. So we called it as B is a kind of A class. Now, if we have to access the properties from one class to another class without using inheritance, so there is a concept called as containership. Now, what the containership will do? Containership will access the contents from one class to another class without using the inheritance. In containership, we place object of one class into another class. So in this way, the properties or the methods or the data members are acquired from one class to another class. Containership is also called as when a class contains objects of another class or its members, this kind of relation is called containership or nesting of classes, which contains the objects of another class as its members is called as container class. For the general syntax, we will see, for example, this is class alpha, in that this contains the class data members or member functions. This is the body of this class alpha. Second class is class beta. So that contains again some kind of its body of class beta. So here we require the contents from class alpha to class beta, but without using any kind of inheritance. So we achieve this property with the help of containership. So what we will do, we will create the object of class alpha into class beta, or we will create the object of one class into another class like this. So one class is alpha, so we create the object of alpha is like this, alpha A, where A is the object of class alpha, and with this object we can call the methods from alpha class or from another class. So let's say if we have to call the show function from alpha class. For example, show function is available into alpha class, and if we have to call this show function, so we'll write it as alpha A and A dot show function. So actually this show function or this member function is available into alpha class, but which is called in beta class. But look at here, no kind of any inheritance is present here. So we get the properties of one class to another class just because of this containership. In a very simple way, we will see one example. Like here we have a class A, in that we have a member function that is show, which displays the statement we using cout, hello from first class. There is another class B which contains one display function. Now actually what we are going to do, we will create the object of class A. We have to call this show function into B class. So we will create the object of class A like this, A class name and obj, where obj is the object of class A. And display is the member function of class B. Now we know that in every kind of execution, main function executes only a member function. So that's why inside a display function, we will call the member function of A class. So that's why we will write it as a obj, where obj is the object of A class. So obj.show, where show is the member function from A class. So obj.show and the cout statement, where cout statement is the part of this display function, which is going to display hello from second class. When we move towards the execution, so execution starts with your main function. Here we have created the object of B class. That is B class object is obj. So B obj and obj.display. So we have called the function display, which is present in B class. Now control moves towards the display function. Inside the display function, first statement is obj.show, where obj is the object of class A and show is the member function from A class. So control directly moves towards the show function and it will execute the statement hello from first class. After printing the statement hello from first class, it will again move towards the display function. So in the display function, it will display the next statement hello from second class. So we'll get the output as a hello from first class and hello from second class as the output. Here some points are to remember that we have created the object of only a B class, but it will execute the function from another class also. Where what we have done, we have created the object of one class into another class. In a general way, we can call it as a classes within classes. Let's say we will execute this program. So for example, if we have a class A, in the public section, let's say we have any kind of member function we can take. So let's say we have a member function show. So let's say void show, which is going to display one statement that this is class A. So we are going to write this into class A. So this is only a show function which is going to display this is the class A. Then we have a separate class B. For just to save time, I will just copy, or let it be, we will write it as a class B. Look at here, we don't have used any kind of inheritance here, but still we are getting the properties from one class to another class. Here again in the public section, let's say we have another function called as display. So let's say display. This is going to show one cout statement. This is class B. Now the important thing is that we will going to create the object of class A into class B. So if we have to execute the show function, so we'll create the object of class A. Let's say here we will going to create before public or after public, we can create the object. So A, and let's say the object is obj1 for the first object. And if we have to call this show function, so we'll call this show function inside any member function. So object one is there, obj1.show, where show is the member function from class A. Now we are going to execute only the display function. Look at here, we will execute only the display function, but inside the display function it will execute the show function also, which is present in class A. So let's say in a main function, we are going to create the object of class B. So B object is obj2, let's say, and we'll create obj2.display. So let's say what will happen. It will execute the display function, and inside the display function we have called the show function with the help of object of class A. So let's say look at the output here. we are getting the output, this is class A and this is class B, where this is class A is a cout statement from show function and this is class B is a cout statement from display function. So with a single object we are going to create, or we can going to show the function from A class and B class also. Now what will happen if we have the class A as a constructor and class B as a constructor, and we are going to create the object of class B. So which constructor will execute first? What do you think? Got the question? For example, this is a class show which is having one constructor show. This is class display which is going to display this thing. What will happen? So it will execute the constructor from base, not base class, from the first class, and then it will execute the constructor from the second class. So let's check the output. Only we need to do one thing, we have to create the object of another class. Here the class name is show. Sorry, another class is display. So see the output. So first constructor is this is class A and second is this is class B. So it will execute the constructor of first class, and then it will execute the constructor from second class, because we have created the object of first initially. So that's why it will execute the constructor from first and then second. So in this way we have studied about the containership, that it will execute the function from one class to another class, or member functions or data members from one class to another class. So without using inheritance we can achieve the same property, but there is a small difference between what we can say containership and inheritance. When we execute the programs we can easily see that the difference. Okay, so kindly like and subscribe to this channel. Thank you.